Hey, I'm Osmond, and I'm a developer here at Sparkbox. Sparkbox is researching and comparing many of the different accessibility tools out there to help teams choose the right tool for them. No tool is perfect, and every project differs in needs. In the past, we've reviewed tools aimed at developers and others who are working with code, but web accessibility should be a consideration throughout the entire process, including the user experience and design stages. That's why today, I'll be reviewing Stark. There are many ways to use the Stark tool, including as a standalone Mac application or a browser extension, but today we'll be focusing on the plugin for the commonly used collaborative design tool, Figma. As such, a familiarity with Figma is one of the requirements for using this tool. The other is a subscription. Stark is a paid service. There are a number of pricing options available on their website, and the best one for you depends on the size of your team. While it is possible to use Stark without signing up for a subscription, many of its features are locked behind the paywall. To get started actually using the tool itself, after creating an account on the Stark website and choosing one of the pricing options, you would have to find and install the Stark plugin in the Figma community and log into your Stark account from within the plugin. Once logged in, you are presented with a menu of the available accessibility tools at your disposal. Let's use the contrast tool as an example. The plugin window is where Stark will give you feedback on your design depending on the tool that you're using. Here, the body paragraph text is level AA and level AAA compliant with WCAG 2.1 color contrast standards, while the link text here is neither. If more guidance or direction is needed on any of Stark's tools, there is a link to Getting Started tutorials found both in your account dashboard and the main website. The tutorials cover how to use the tool and why certain accessibility considerations are important. While there are no direct links to the WCAG 2.1 standards within the plugin, you can find some in the documentation. Where Stark really shines is the features that aid in designer-to-developer handoff, removing a lot of the guesswork and the back and forth that can happen with the design team. For example, page landmarks such as the header, footer, or any asides can be denoted within the design. Additionally, the alt text tool allows designers to suggest alt text for any images, as well as whether or not that alt text is needed at all. On the other hand, there are some Stark features that could be improved. Using the contrast tool as an example again, if a designer were to accept one of the color suggestions, then only the individual element would be updated and any corresponding library color styles would not. While this protects the library from being modified with any arbitrary updates, if a designer were to apply color suggestions in several locations without updating the corresponding styles, this could lead to a design with many stray styles. The typography tool has this issue as well. Additionally, it would be helpful for the typography tool to analyze other attributes of text that might make it harder to read. Currently, Stark will provide feedback on whether text is too small or make comments on the alignment, but something like making sure the text has a sufficient line height would also be helpful. All that being said, Stark is still in active development, and the team is adding new features, as well as taking feature requests. Stark is unique in the accessibility tool space, where it is analyzing web pages at the design stage before any code has been written. So the Stark team faces some challenges that those building tools that is essentially scanning the code do not have. As the tool stands today, it can help bridge some of the gap between designer and developer. If you're looking for more accessibility tools, check out our playlist with more Sparkbox accessibility tool reviews. For a full review of Stark for Figma, check out the link to the article in the description below.